This is Sudhushi. Welcome back to my channel. Here I talk about modeling and simulation of nanomaterials. This video is a part of a series where I discuss how to get started with deep learning for materials. And the biggest roadblock on that way is how do you represent your atomic structure as an input to neural networks? Well, there are several ways to do so. I introduced some of them in my earlier videos, so you can watch those. But here, I'm going to talk about a method that is applicable to not just ordered crystalline systems, but also to amorphous systems. Here, I'm going to discuss this method as well as an easy way how can you convert your structure to input for a neural network using a package. So, stay tuned.
Last video, we spoke of some descriptors, adjacency matrix, Coulomb matrix, bag of bonds, that can be used to input an atomic structure as numeric matrix to neural networks. These methods encode information about atomic bonds with varying level of accuracy and can be fed to neural networks instead of Cartesian coordinates. You can find the link to that video in description section below. Now, these methods are fairly easy, but they come with limitations. They are more effective on ordered atomic structures or crystal systems. What will you do if your structure is amorphous or dynamic complex system? Secondly, these were global descriptors. That means they encode information of the entire structure into a matrix as a whole, like a snapshot. You cannot separate information pertaining to any local sector in the structure. These two issues are resolved in a method called atom-centered symmetry functions. This method was first given by Behler in 2007, and since then it has been actively used in vast range of studies on materials. It has been successful on crystals, liquids, amorphous, and all kind of solids. In this video, I will share details of ACSF method and also how you can calculate them using a package. So what can you expect in this video? I will first introduce you to a package designed specifically to convert Cartesian coordinates to neural network inputs and a descriptor of your choice. Then I will show you how I calculated ACSF for my systems without really doing any calculations or writing any complicated code. And then I will discuss more theory about ACSF and how should you choose your parameters accurate for your structure. So, converting structure to input matrix can be time consuming by oneself and can involve complicated coding. I found an easy way. I use describe package in Python that can turn your atomic structure into a numerical matrix of fixed size. This package covers range of descriptors, as you can see here, from Coulomb matrix to many body tensor representation. You can choose your pick. Installation. Before we move to descriptors, you need to install this package. Well, the installation is quite easy and similar to any other Python package. Besides, you also need to install Atomic Simulation Environment, ASE. Since Describe use ASE to work with atomic structures, you need this package. Now let me show you a sample script for Describe, which can be used to get ACSF for your atomic structure. In this Python script, we first import all the necessary packages. ASE is imported as directed in tutorial of Describe website. We next import ACSF descriptor from Describe package. In this script, we would need NumPy, Matplot library, and Pandas as well. We use these packages to convert the ACSF output into a matrix written in CSV file. You can change those sections as per your requirement. Next, we define a function where postcard is read and converted to ACSF descriptors. Postcard is a file that contains Cartesian coordinates of your atomic structure. Now, of course, what I'll show you here will only make sense when I discuss the theory of ACSF later in this video. So at that time, you can come back to this section of this video and go through this again. So this function is sent an input file and an output file name. The two arguments are input file in a .wasp format, which will be sent to the function, and an output file, which will be generated inside the function. Again, input file is in .wasp format here. Now, this is where the function is being called. So inside the function, str reads the input file in postcard format with .wasp extension. We must define the species of the atom this postcard has. Now we define parameters for ACSF descriptors. These parameters are unique for every atomic system, and their choice will determine how accurate are your ACSF descriptors. Significance of each parameter is discussed later, but if you are working with another descriptor, such as SOAP, this is another example of where descriptor parameters are defined. Moving back to ACSF, we recognize species and then whether the structure is periodic or not. We define the R-cut. The R-cut is the cutoff radius around the atom until which interactions are taken into account. And now, G2 and G4 are ACSF specific parameters. You can find the link to their explanation in the comment below. Once ACSF parameters are defined for a given structure, we create a numeric matrix using acsf.create command. Watch this video till the end to know more about G2 and G4. Now we convert this matrix to data frame and then write it in a CSV format with name, output file name. Outside this function, location of input and output is defined. We use this last section to name output file after the input file name and then call the function. I hope the basic structure of this code is understood. You can change these settings as per your choice. Now let me show you what selected parameters are actually. Let me explain some theory behind ACSF. Now ACSF is originally designed for high dimensional neural networks. Again, I have already spoken about it in another video. Link is present in the description section. In these neural networks, energy is considered component of atomic energy contributions. Each atom's energy is determined and added together to give a system's energy. That means local environment of each atoms become important and need to be defined. ACSF targets defining local environment of atoms within a certain cutoff radius by means of functions that define radial and angular functions of each atom in the system. Radial and angular information of neighbors is built into ACSF G2 and G4 functions. Now, of course, cutoff radius of an atom is very important. The number of neighbors in the local environment of each atom cannot be fixed. In that case, it can get difficult to construct a neural network. Symmetry functions ensure that input vector is of fixed size. Now first, for every neighboring atom in the cutoff radius, a cutoff function is defined. Here, Rij is the distance between two atoms. Radial functions are constructed as the sum of two body terms. Now you can have sum of cutoff functions as a radial function G1, but another radial function G2 is used in most studies, which is Gaussians multiplied with cutoff function. Here, eta defines the width of Gaussian and RS is the shift in the center of Gaussians that you would like. Usually RS is kept zero so that the center of Gaussian is maintained at the reference atom. To people who might wonder what a Gaussian curve is, it is a bell-shaped curve. It is assumed that during any measurements, values will follow a normal distribution with an equal number of measurements above and below the mean value. This figure represents Gaussian distribution. Now, as I mentioned, eta is the width of Gaussian curve. In the expression of Gaussian function, the width of Gaussian is the standard deviation and the function is inversely proportional to eta value. This has also been shown in the research study by Behler. So it is advisable to keep eta values small for broader coverage, as you can see here. Now let me show you where values of eta and RS are defined in the code which I showed you earlier. These G2 parameters that you see here, this is where you define eta and RS. Of course, values written here are random. Don't follow these values. Now let us assume these are your G2 parameters. Here, the first value is eta, defining width of the Gaussian, and the second value is rs, defining center of Gaussian. Now you must be wondering, what are the other sets? Well, for complex systems, it is difficult to guarantee success with just one radial function. So it is advisable to write many parameters for complete description of chemical space. As you can see, different eta values will provide different coverage of chemical space. So we write multiple sets of parameters for each system. Here, for example purposes, I have given just three, but you can actually choose this based on your structure, literature survey, and optimization results. Now the same goes for eta values. You have to find the optimum eta value for your structure by thorough literature survey and optimization. Now let's discuss how can you incorporate angular information. There are two types of angular symmetry functions defined, G4 and G5, which sum over three body components, three atoms centered at reference atom I. These functions include sum of cosine functions of angle theta ijk centered at reference atom I. You can use either, but I personally prefer G4 over G5 because G5 is not constrained by cutoff radius and can have larger terms in the summation. Now in G4, you notice several new terms. Of course, Rij, Rik, and Rjk are distances between the three atoms. The new terms are theta ijk, lambda, and psi. Let's discuss the significance of each of these three. As I've already mentioned, theta ijk is the angle centered at atom I. Lambda shifts the maxima of cosine function cos theta ijk, as you can see here. If lambda is plus 1, the maxima of cosine function is focused at 0 degrees. If lambda is negative, maxima is focused at 180 degrees. Notice the blue portions in lambda equals to 1 and lambda equals to minus 1, they are flipped from 0 to 180 degrees. What we have next is psi, which is the resolution. As you notice, small values of psi covers angular resolution from 90 to 270 degrees, centered at 0 when lambda equals to 1. As we increase the psi, resolution also decreases with center remaining at 0 degrees for lambda equals to 1. Therefore, we prefer to keep psi values small for broader coverage and resolution. Now, where do we define these parameters in the script? G4 parameters are defined right after G2 parameters. The first parameter here is eta, for Gaussian is included in G4 and is same as G2 parameters. Next term is defined here is psi, which is 1 for broad angular coverage. The last term is lambda, which can be either plus 1 or minus 1. This is how angular space is covered with plus 1 and minus 1 lambda. So to cover the entire space, we use both plus 1 and minus 1 as different parameter sets for every Gaussian and psi value. You can also observe here the resolution becomes narrower for psi as psi values are increased. I will remind you once again, purpose of this video is to explain you the terms of symmetry function. You need to find optimum parameter set for your structure. You can try using this method to represent your structure and let me know in comment section if you have any questions. But before that, do not forget to like the video if it was useful and subscribe to my channel for future updates. Thank you.